It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie in the morning. We're joined by a friend of Kiss Breakfast. He is home. Give it up for Dizzy.
What's
going on, brother?
How you been, brother?
I'm all right.
You still look naughty.
When he came in and he hugged Charlie, what did you say? Yeah, yeah. Man was excited.
I miss her, man.
You know what? I miss you as well. It's been a long time.
High five. So, Diz, I saw some pictures online the other day, you and Robbie, kind of like on these kind of like mobility scooters that look like Harley Davidson's, kind of
done up like that.
Souped up. And Charlie showed me like a car that's been kind of like got spikes all over it and stuff. What's the video about? Tell us what the video is about.
The theme was kind of like Quadrophenia, if anyone's seen it.
Yeah.
That classic film is like mods and rockers. But it's set today, so they all would be old.
Right, okay.
And the thing about the video is going to be about in a minute as well. The video, it was shot in one take.
Really?
Whoa.
That was what made it
special, right? Okay,
we had to do it all in one, and that was interesting.
Did you do it in one take?
We did it in 22 takes. But that's not the point.
Now, Dizzy, you've been spending a lot of time in LA. How did the hookup between you and Robbie Williams come about?
The song was already done before Robbie was brought into the equation.
Right.
Last year with a guy called Tim Anderson. I can't remember who the other guy on it originally was as well. But Tim Anderson he was in a band called I'm a Robot.
Okay.
And when he showed me the track, I was just got proper excited because I'm always trying to do something different, isn't
something it? New, yeah.
But with this one, it had the guitars in it. It just felt like indie time, and I just feel like there's gonna be a shift in radio, like this year or in the next coming years. The guitars have to come back. It's a guitar nation. It's
what
I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
So I got excited about it. Plus, it had a little bit of the disco thing to it and all that as well.
Yeah.
So I was like, I love that. Then it weren't until like this year that Robbie's name got called up involved, and I got proper excited about it, obviously, because. At first, I didn't think of that, but then it made total sense.
Complete sense.
What the song's about, and then the way he sung it as well, it's good.
You're saying as well, like, you've got the whole disco sound in it. Because a lot of people saying, like, the new Daft Punk track is the sound for the summer. I don't personally think it is.
Right.
Could your track be a contender? Because I don't think we have found the track for the summer yet.
This is, everyone I've played this to, even before I had Robbie on it, was super excited about it, especially... When it comes, I haven't done it live yet. I don't know why I've done it live yet, but I haven't done it live yet. But it's a like massive festival tune.
Right.
It's a massive radio record. And it's one that I'm saying some stuff in it, but it's a good sing-along.
Yeah.
So are you, I just got tickets for you to go and see Robbie actually at the O2. So does this mean that you're going to end up?
I didn't get no tickets.
But surely you can go and perform.
You lot are mates now, surely.
The thing is, I can't wait to see that because of you live and Robbie live is a problem.
Yeah.
So together, that's an explosion right
there.
That'd
be fun. And we get on as people very well.
You can see that.
Well.
You can see that in the pictures and stuff. You guys look like you're proper on a level.
Well, it's mad. When I went to, this was one of the few songs on my album that I actually got to sit there and work with the artist.
Right.
I mean, so I went to his house in LA.
Really?
Which is mental.
What's his house like?
When we got to, it's like in a complex in LA somewhere, like, I can't remember the name of there, it's in some kind of valley or something like that.
Right.
And when I got there, I remember getting out of the car, I was with Cage, I was looking around like, was this some Jurassic Park movie? Like that. And when we got in there, we got talking, we talked about loads of stuff. He is a lunatic. He's cool, he's wicked, yeah? But he's the house that he lives in, they wrote Ghostbusters in.
Really?
Seriously?
No.
And outside of his house, which makes sense when I got there and I thought this looks like some movie or something, is the opening scene to E.T.
Are you serious?
That's what it was.
What?
I don't know if he wants me to be saying all this, but this amazing thing about life to have been to see that, you know what I mean?
That's massive.
But we just got on and spoke about a load of things. Cage was there as well. We was just joking about. So we just clicked.
Yeah.
So it was easy to work. And I got to watch Robbie Williams like lay vocals,
so
just whether in my song or not, you know what I mean? Just get to watch
that's
him.
A big look.
That's it.
You could have brought him along. Today, I mean, it's nice seeing you, but it'd be nice to see both of you.
Stalker, you're watching
himself.
Number one stalker here for Robbie Williams.
I'm going to get you them backstage
after
tickets.
You.
Yeah,
know. Well, Dizzy, can we hear this track right now? Yes. Going crazy.
Yeah, man.
On Kiss.
That's it, bro.
Right now, this is Dizzy Rascal, Robbie Williams, yep, going yep, crazy yep, on yep, Kiss yep, Breakfast.
Yep, yep. Yeah. Lovely, lovely. All right, can I just say, right, listening to that track, straight up anthems. Yeah. Straight up anthems. I can hear people playing that on every single, every single, like, TV station, radio. So it's going to go, like, worldwide.
That's why I'm happy about it, because it's I feel like I've stepped into a new thing as well. I've reinvented myself again.
Do you know what? I was listening to it and thinking, this is like when Jay-Z worked with Linkin Park.
Yeah, yeah,
do you know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
that's
yeah,
that,
yeah,
that type
wicked,
of vibe.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And obviously, Robbie's such a legend.
Exactly. He's a big deal.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
So and the key is you didn't let him rap on it. You wasn't staying true to yourself.
Do you know what's crazy? I was going to work with Robbie a long time ago.
Really? Right?
He had this song called Rude Box.
Yes, we remember that. Yeah. I was about to say that.
Yeah.
I'm glad you didn't, to be honest.
Yeah, it didn't end up working out. Right?
Thank God for that.
Yeah, but, yeah, you know what I mean? But the link was there still in there, man. Yeah. And I'm glad we got to do it this time. And it sounds natural. It sounds comfortable. Yes. You know what I mean? Because I know to people as well, I'm super skeptical when I do watch what people say and all that about what I'm doing and that. Like, but it's good that it doesn't feel forced.
Yeah.
And it's not crap. It could just be the two things, just seeing the two names together, you could be skeptical.
I just want to see you both on a stage, to be honest.
It's gonna
be
just fun,
think
man.
That'll be like next level. I really can't wait. Hurry up, make it happen.
Definitely.
Right, so Dizzy, where can we see this video for this track, Going Crazy?
You can see it at dirtytv.com, you can see it on Vivo, and then it's going to be everywhere else after that.
9 a.m. today, yeah? All right, get involved. Yeah. Give it up for Dizzy Rascal.
We love it. Yeah.
Yes, please.
We love coming up here.